From unimaginably dense forests hosting endless winding trails and all manner of ghoulish creature, to aged prisons whose long dormant cells are rumored to be stalked by the restless spirits of prisoners still serving time from beyond the grave, are you prepared to explore some of the most haunted places in New Jersey? Number 5, the Flanders Hotel. The Flanders Hotel, located off East 11th Street in Ocean City, New Jersey, is a beachfront lodging establishment boasting the title of being the only full-service hotel in the whole of the city. Boasting elegant ballrooms, meeting spaces, a full-service restaurant, specialty shops, a salon and spa, a heated outdoor pool, a business center, and fitness accommodations. Historically, the structure was built in 1923 under the Oceanfront Hotel Corporation by architect Vivian Smith, who chose to feature Spanish colonial revival style in this work. Initially, the site was managed by one J. Howard Slocum until 1932, when Elwood F. Kirkman acquired ownership, and in 1996, the property was purchased by James M. Dwyer, who would convert the hotel into luxury condos for daily rentals, which he would open to the public the following year in 97. In light of a number of financial setbacks, Mr. Dwyer was eventually removed from all hotel dealings, and in 2005, a board of trustees was installed in his stead. In the present, the Flanders Hotel acts as a popular vacation destination year-round, with accommodations ranging from luxury suites to impressive penthouses. More recently, this prestigious site has picked up a reputation for its chilling paranormal activity, with both staff and guests reporting doors that open and close on their own, lights that flicker and bulbs that literally unscrew themselves, and the soothing yet somehow foreboding disembodied sounds of a young girl heard singing from the hall. The most famous legend surrounding the Flanders tells of one Emily, a young lady in her 20s whose boyfriend went away to World War I, but sadly never returned. Her ghost has been known to manifest about the hotel as a woman in white and has been described as displaying a cheerful demeanor, often while playing small pranks on the living. Number 4, Burlington County Prison Museum. Burlington County Prison Museum, located off of High Street in Mount Holly, New Jersey, is a former lockup-turned-museum that, at the time of its closure, actually held the mantle of being the oldest operating prison in the country. Historically, construction of the prison was started in 1810, with its design led by Robert Mills, who prioritized functional accommodations across his progressive layout, utilizing individual cells, solid ventilation, and fireproof construction, and by 1811, the site would welcome its first inmates. The finished design would form a three-story U-shaped main structure, with two wings extending off the rear at either end of the street-facing side of the central section. Cells varied drastically, with some purposed to hold groups, others for solo prisoners, and a solitary confinement cell for excessively dangerous prisoners housed on the top floor, complete with wall-mounted shackles. The prison would continue to operate until 1965, after which it was converted for museum use, and in 1986 it would be designated as a National Historic Landmark. The museum remains open into the present and is operated by a local nonprofit who offers both guided and self-guided touring options. Chillingly, countless executions, which were offered up as public events, were held within the prison's yard. Many violent deaths occurred on site, and local legend claims resulting restless spirits linger, with both staff and visitors reporting orbs and strange mists in photography, high EMF levels, chilling EVPs, objects sighted moving on their own, inexplicable malfunctions with cellular devices, and encounters with the manifestation of a tall man in uniform deep within the basement. One more popular story tells of Joel Clow, a 29-year-old man who stabbed a woman to death for turning him down, and who managed to escape from the prison, only to be recaptured and confined in the third-floor max security cell until his execution in the yard. Joel's spirit is rumored to remain in the max security cell, and can often be heard sobbing and moaning as he continues to wait out his final hours into eternity. Number 3, the Absecon Lighthouse. the Absecon Lighthouse, located off of South Rhode Island Avenue in Atlantic City, New Jersey, is a historic navigational aid that, at 171 feet in height, holds the records of being the tallest lighthouse in the state, as well as of being the fourth tallest in the entirety of the U.S. Historically, construction of a tower on site was started in 1854, with the first light illuminated on January 15th of 1857. It would serve faithfully for many years, until its deactivation in 1933, and although the light continues to run at night, it no longer does so for official navigational purposes. In 2002, a keeper's quarters was opened up to serve as a museum and gift shop. While lighthouse grounds are open to the public for visitation, for a small donation, one can actually climb up to the watch room and external gallery. Alongside accommodating a number of school projects and tour groups, the Absecon Light offers a wide variety of special events annually, including a winter arts program for kids and an overnight program for scouts. Through the years, a number of local legends have formed surrounding this aged aid, and both staff and visitors to the site have reported disembodied voices and footsteps heard from the tower, the sounds of a crowd when no one else is around, objects sighted moving on their own, the phantom smell of pipe tobacco, and the commotion of a baby crying heard emanating from thin air. Rather tragically, the wreck of the Powhatan, which resulted in 311 fatalities, was the inciting incident that initially prompted construction of the light. Before it, several other deadly shipwrecks occurred near, and many roaming the area have described ghostly vessels that appear suddenly in surrounding waters, gliding silently past before disappearing in the blink of an eye. Lastly, the apparitions of former lighthouse keepers, family members, and aides have been encountered. Ghostly forms are often captured in photography and video, and it's documented that in 1909, lightkeeper Frank Adams fired his shotgun at what he swore was the Jersey Devil, and that whatever it was let out a spine-tingling shriek before flying off into the night. Number 2, Jenny Jump State Forest. Jenny Jump State Forest, located off State Park Road out of Hope, New Jersey, is a 4,466-acre state park expanse stretching along the 1,112-foot-high and 6-mile-long Jenny Jump mountain ridge, whose encompassing forests are rumored to be haunted by the ghost of the girl after which the site takes its name. According to local legend, long ago the Mincy tribe of the Lenni Lenape would happen upon a young girl named Jenny and her father while scouting the mountain's edge, and fearing she would be taken or killed, the father would call out to her, "Jump, Jenny, jump!" Historically, through the early 1900s, two men would dam a nearby creek, creating Ghost Lake, from which a number of locals were able to get fresh water. In 1931, the region was officialized as Jenny Jump State Forest in an effort to conserve the mountain and its woodlands, and in 1995, the Greenwood Observatory was constructed by the United Astronomy Clubs of New Jersey. Today, Jenny Jump State Forest offers 7 formidable trails, campsites of all varieties, and even shelters. As a bit of trivia, Jenny Jump is one of only a handful of dark sky locations in the state of New Jersey, meaning that from it, the night sky is at its most visible. Over the years, a number of campfire tales have been birthed within Jenny Jump, the most prominent of which surrounds the fate of young Jenny. Many claim that after hearing her father's command, Jenny did indeed jump to her death, and that one can usually find her spirit wandering the cliffs in a white or blue and white dress, with a melancholy look upon her face. Other stories tell of how Ghost Lake is often covered in dense fog despite crystalline weather conditions elsewhere, and more chilling tales concerning grisly murders or desecrated native burial sites paint ghoulish figures emerging from its depths. Adjacent to the lake sits a cave known as the Fairy Hole, which some claim is filled with intense energies, and possibly actual fairy folk. Lastly, the infamous Shades of Death Road runs right along Jenny Jump, and several theories exist as to how this dark drive earned its moniker. One theory tells that preceding the road's formation, the area played host to a number of highway robberies and murders. Another, that a local malaria outbreak killed hundreds nearby. And another still, that native grave sites were cleared in order to plot out the route. Legend tells that on this road, a ghostly man in traditional native attire has been known to shapeshift into a white-tailed deer before leaping in front of cars, and it's claimed that any who might hit this white tail will surely be followed by bad luck or even death. Number 1. Rowan University. Rowan University, located off Mullica Hill Road in Glassboro, New Jersey, is a public research university recognized nationally for its commitment to high-quality yet affordable education. Historically, in 1917, 107 residents would raise funds and pool the resources necessary to purchase 25 acres from one Whitney family locally, after which this land was donated for the construction of a normal school, which in 1923 would open its doors as the Glassbury Normal School, with a class of just 236 female students. In 1934, the school would evolve to accommodate a four-year program, and in 1937, it would be renamed as the New Jersey State Teachers College at Glassboro, after which it would welcome a co-educational student base. Through World War II, enrollment rates would tank, and the student populace would drop to just 170. However, following an Allied victory in 1945, the college would go on to thrive, and would found additional campuses and academic programs over the years, re-establishing itself as Glassboro State College in 1958. Through the 1990s, industrialist Henry M. Rowan Jr. and his wife would donate more than $100 million to the school, which altered its name to Rowan College of New Jersey in their honor. And in 1997, upon claiming status, it would re-establish itself once more as Rowan University. Rowan University remains open into the present, accommodating a formidable enrollment of around 20,000 students across 14 different colleges and schools. Over its lengthy existence, a number of campus legends of the paranormal variety have formed, and across the university's expanse, both faculty and students have reported objects sighted moving on their own, disembodied voices and footsteps heard from empty spaces, and ghostly figures sighted darting around corners or through the windows of buildings that are closed and locked up for the night. Bunce Hall, which acted as the original campus building, is said to be a hotspot for the otherworldly, and within, many have described strange thuds, bumps, and creaking heard at all times of the day, doors that open and close on their own, extreme cold spots, the sensations of being touched or grabbed by someone unseen, and shadowy figures that stalk the living. A more commonly encountered manifestation at Bunce is rumored to be that of the university's first drama teacher, one Elizabeth Toole, or more affectionately, Liz, who's been known to appear at random, startling all those nearby. Lastly, the ghost of Thomas Whitney, to whom the university's land originally belonged, has been sighted roaming about, an astounded look upon his face, and has been known to disappear when approached. Taking its fascinating history into account and coupling it with a formidable slew of supernatural activity, we felt Rowan University was the perfect choice as the most haunted place in New Jersey. Thanks for tuning in for our picks for some of the most haunted places in New Jersey. If you enjoyed our histories and ghost stories, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, throw us a like, and share us with anyone you feel deserves a good scare. We'll catch you all next time.